So for a quick dessert or a midnight snack, and honest to goodness, you can get up and make this at midnight. It's that quick and easy. We are going to make a brownie in the breakfast maker. Remember this?
Oh, yeah, right. Likely story.
Hey, don't lie. I've never made this before, but someone has made this before.
I have, and they are delicious.
I know. So here's what we're going to do. We are going to put flour, 2 to 3 tablespoons of flour in here. Now, this is a half tablespoon, which comes with the Tupperware measuring set, mm-hmm. which is kind of cool because right now my tablespoon is wet, so I'm just going to use it for the the wet ingredients. Did we lose track? I think that's you at home while you're watching
how
the
many
video.
Were you putting in there?
You're going to have to comment and tell me if I put too much in. Then we're going to put in hot chocolate powder, 2 packages. Okay, and you'll note that if you buy the big can of hot chocolate powder, this is 25 grams. So in total, we're going to put in 50 grams of hot chocolate mix. Interesting, hey? Mm-hmm. And Mom, what do we keep the flour in?
In
the modular mate.
Oh, a modular mate, right.
And why do we do that?
To keep it fresh, bug-free, dry.
Exactly.
And it stacks beautifully in a cupboard or a drawer or a shelf.
Exactly.
And they're just the best.
3 years.
Whoops. Just the best.
Got a stray hair here, and we do not want that in the brownie.
I'd have to kill you.
I know. Despite the fact I have my hair back, I shake everything off before I start. They still happen.
Well, you got enough hair for 14 people, so.
Well, not quite, but you know.
Yeah.
Okay, vanilla. We're going to put in 1/4 teaspoon. Let's see how we do. I'm scared. There we go. And we are going to use canola oil. We are going to put in, oh, there's my tablespoon. 2 tablespoons of canola oil. These are the counterscapers. They're not in the catalogs right now, which is kind of sad. But a lot of Tupperware people keep some stock around, so you can always call them if you're interested in those and see if they have any.
Yeah, they're great containers too.
So nice for oils and anything liquid like that. Flour, canola oil, water. 2 tablespoons of water. And this is the micro pitcher. Microwave safe. Pretty awesome. I'm putting in a little more just because I didn't get level teaspoons because I'm doing it with my left hand and I'm totally impaired. Okay, we're going to give that a little mix with my spatula that is way too big, but I've been cooking all day and it's the only one I have left. Everything else is drying right now.
You should call a Tupperware dealer.
I'm guessing we might have a spatula around somewhere downstairs.
Yeah, I'm guessing we would too.
So there we go. Nice little batter. Pretty. Mm-hmm. Looks just like cake batter.
It does.
I'm going to put it into the breakfast maker. By the way, love the That's a Bowl with the handles.
Yeah, those are great bowls. Yes. And I love having them all in different sizes. And they're great for storing stuff. Like if we have leftovers, they are the best.
Yep.
Plus, they're all different colors. It's kind of neat.
I know, it's true.
I used to think sets were wonderful, but I don't know. Sometimes it's nice to have a mixture of colors.
Exactly. And then that's a bowl because they have a round seal, airtight and liquid tight. So I love them for taking stuff to potlucks and things.
Yeah.
Because they're... if you dress your salad or anything.
Yeah.
Nothing bad is going to happen.
Well, and that's why they're so nice for storage in the fridge. Like,
right?
It's, you know, leftovers for the next day or a couple of 3 days down the road.
Exactly. Not chocolatey enough, so we're going to take 1/4 cup of chocolate chips, which I'm going to measure by hand. Now, because this is a steamer, it is not like the hard plastic, like the micro pitchers. Okay, so if you're putting cheese or anything in chocolate chips, anything sugary like that,
mm-hmm.
you want to make sure you get it not touching
right up against
the sides.
Yeah.
Yep. So you kind of just sprinkle this throughout the middle and the near edges, but make sure there's nothing touching. And there we go. We're going to put on our cover. We're going to microwave for 60 to 90 seconds. You always have to play with your microwaves because they're all different. And then we'll take the lid off and unveil it for you.
Yay!
All right, the moment of truth is here.
Ooh, boy, I can smell
doesn't
it.
Doesn't it? I know, it smells delicious. So chocolatey. Oh. Okay, so here remember, steam, open away from you.
Oh, yummy. Can you believe that?
Doesn't that look quick? Oops, that's really hot. Be careful,
yes.
Guys. That looks really good. I did 90 seconds in my 1,000 watt microwave. So we're going to let that cool down for like a second.
Or five.
And then we're going to eat it. So there you go. Midnight snack, quick dessert, whatever works for you. Breakfast. It is a breakfast maker.
Yeah, right.
Okay. Enjoy the recipe. See you later.